Hello everyone, this is Nitish from Byte Scout, and what we are going to do today is create a simple tutorial to show how states work in Alpine.js. So initially what we're going to do is create a simple HTML page, and inside it we're going to create a head section and then move on to create the body section and add in a simple div. This div is very important because, as we already learned, that the state has to be in the scope of the section that you're choosing. Basically, if you create a state in the Alpine.js, then all the elements within that section will also get the state, will get access to a state. So we will get into it in a while. So next, what we could do is create a h1 in where we type welcome to Byte Scout Alpine.js tutorial, and then next we create a button as well. This button will come a lot handy, will come handy in a while. You will see how we use it. We name it this as toggle, and then next we are going to see this our page looks like this. So after we create the structure, we have to basically use a CDN and copy and to make the Alpine.js available to this HTML page. To do that, we'll go to the GitHub repository and copy this CDN from there and paste it on our code. Once done, we are now ready to add the state to this HTML code. As you can see, there's nothing is currently dynamic in nature. Everything is shown as recorded right now. So we have already created a div tag, we are going to add a state here. We do that with the help of xData attribute, and as we know, like xData actually accept an object, a string. So we create that within, and in within this we create is open and set it to true. So when we do that, it's basically creating the state xData, and we can use it on our elements which is within the div tag. Next, what we do is to use the state we use the xShow attribute, and in within this it's we set the is open here. So when you basically, as is open is set to true, so if you go there you will see this as it is showing there. But if we just change the state to false, it will basically not show because we have set the xShow to is open, with which is currently set to false. Now this behavior is very common in web pages. So now right next we have to do is basically put this behavior to the toggle button. To do so, what we'll do is use the x on click attribute, which is available in Alpine as well, and we set the is open to not is open. Basically we changing the state of the is open. It's currently boolean, it's either on or off, as you can see. So once we do that, we save the file, we go here, you see that it's loaded, there's nothing. So but when we click on toggle, it will show the h1 content here. So this is a very simple implementation, and as we go further, you will see more complex implementation in slideshows, images and sidebar. That's it for now.